Bonehead Brothers. That's right.
My relative did that. I'm serious.
Lovely.
Kemet, here you are. Before the Grand Master himself, Osama At Ra, Septepen Ra, Ramessu Mariamman of the 19th dynasty. That's Ramessu II, the four massive colossals that you see him sitting on his Haru throne. Now the colossal that you see right here that's fallen, some say that that was due to an earthquake. We're not sure, because we know how the plunders have come through. Is that right?
That's right.
Here we see this facade is 100 feet tall, and the colossal statues are 65 feet tall. The Grand Master himself and one of the greatest structures that he built right here in Abu Simbel. Dedicated to Ra Harakhte that you see right in the facade of the temple, meaning the rising of the sun. Here the Grand Master here got his Tajeti. That means his grandmaster builder, May, to build this structure for him. Like I said, just like Imhotep, who built for Zosernetiket, and also like Zosimankh, who built for Sneferu, and Ankhuf, who built for Khufu, the grandmaster's name here who built this is named May. At the top, you see the Mhetet Ra. You see 24 Mhetet Ra, or baboons. These baboons were sacred to Kemet because it represented the 24 hours of the day. But here you see 24 hours that Ra gives us time. Mhetet Ra, the sacred baboon, associated with Ra because he gives praise to the sun as it rises in the east. So the Zoop type, or the zoomorphic type, is the baboon that you see on the top of the facade. Then also down by his legs, you see his wife, Nefertari, the most beautiful, Nefertari II. But this whole structure was dismantled. It was 200 feet down in the water. To save it, they had to take it apart piece by piece and 20,000 tons of rocks, stone, cutting it out and setting it 600 feet back where you presently see it at today. So it's not in its original position, but fortunately, it was saved for us to see. On the right side, you'll see the Ta-Nehisi, or Nubians. On the left side going in, you'll see the Hittite forces. Now, we had our own civil war. Now, I've heard other guys say that those are slaves on the other side. Those are not slaves. They are captives of war, just like you have the captives of war of the Hittites. And keep in mind that Nefertari is the queen that he married. She is a Ta-Nehisi. Who is he marrying? He's marrying his beginning. What is his beginning? Ta-Nehisi, the mother of Tameri. Here, the temple sits on the south. Nefertari sits on the north side. Look at both of the temples here, structures here, because here we see this great Sutan king who had 50 wives, but was that one wife, Nefertari, who was the most special wife, that he built a temple for her. That wasn't done again until Taj Mahal did the same thing for his wife. But where was it started at first? It started right here. As Ra rises in the east, the temple was set on his axis, and all the way down to the hypostyle hall that Ra would rise in back of the temple. Now, when you go inside, there are 8 colossal statues of Ursima At Ra, Septepen Ra, in Osirian position. The Osirian position, 2 feet together, and he's standing like this, going all the way to the back of the Ankh Manu, or the Holies of the Holies. In the back of the Holies of the Holies, he has made himself one with the divine Netters. That means to the far left is Ptah. Ptah, who is the architect of the universe, who's the one that says, let there be light. After that, we see it is Amun, and then Ramessu, and Ra Harakhte, all the way in the back of the Ankh Manu, or the most holy place of the temple. On the temple, you'll see the continuous stories of his battles of Kadesh, the battles that he fought with the Hittite forces. You see the massive colossals of this Grand Master sitting on the throne. And we've been mentioning this great Sutan's name, Ursima At Ra Septepen Ra Ramessu Mariamman of the 19th dynasty around 1298 to 1232 BCE, before the Christian era. His royal name, Ursa, the power, Ma'at, truth, justice, and righteousness. Under Ra, God, Septep and Ra. He's chosen by Ra. Ramessu, he's born of Ra, and he's loved by Amun. As you see him on the royal chenoos right here, sitting on the Nepti. That's the name where Nubia came from, Nepti meaning gold. Ursa is the power of Ma'at, truth, justice, and righteousness for the Sutan king to sit on the throne, okay? Under God, Ra. Septepen Ra. He's chosen by Ra. He's chosen by God. Ramessu, he's born of Ra. Okay? Muri, Amun, he's loved by Amun. That is the royal name of Ursa, Ma'at, Ra, Septepen Ra, Ramessu, Muri, Amun, his royal throne name. Not Ramses II that you're most familiar with, Ramses, but Ramessu, if we say it for short. Chosen, Septepen Ra, this is where European Jews get God's chosen children. It came out of Septepen Ra. Ra chose the first people. God chose the first people to be on the planet were African people. All anthropological records have documented that African people were the first people on the planet Earth. Ra has kissed you from the dawn of time. That's why you got melanin. You do not reflect the sun. You pull in the sun. You have melanin. So he knew he was chosen by Ra. So we should all know Septepen Ra. You're chosen by Ra. Because Ra has kissed you from the dawn of time. That's why you have melanin. Color of that succulent kiss that Ra has kissed you now down in Abu Simbel where you are right now, seriously giving you a succulent kiss. All right? He's born of Ra. Okay? Your melanin telling you that you're born of Ra. Okay? He's loved of Amen. The same Amen that you say at the end of your prayers. We have no idea that it came from here. Amen.
Amen.
So when we say Amen, we should say Amen and put Amen in your mind. Amen. Now we're going to say his name collectively together because this is the Grand Master who built. So as our ancestor said, to speak one's name is to make them live again. Yes. So we say his name together. Ursa.
Ursa.
Ma'at Ra.
Ma'at Ra.
Septepen Ra.
Septepen Ra.
Ramessu Muri Amun. May your spirit.
May your spirit
fly,
fly
on the wings of Ra,
on the wings of Ra,
for eternal life,
for eternal life.
We, your ancestors,
your children,
will walk in the Nisiemsu,
walk in the Nisiemsu,
trample down all the evil and lies about they told about you,
trample down all the evil and lies told about you,
so your spirit can fly into the wings of eternity,
so your spirit can fly into the wings of eternity.
Hotep.
Hotep.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Give homage to this Grand Master.
He was one of the black wonders of the world. Yes, he was.
Yeah.
Sisters of the world.